Hello, and today we are with Simon Faure-Field, who is the CEO of Equal Strategy. Good afternoon to you, Simon.
Good afternoon.
Simon, now you're working in a very unusual field within the hospitality industry. We all know scent and sound technology. What briefly is scent and sound technology, please?
We're helping hoteliers create environments that their guests basically fall in love with. It's a space that people are going to connect with, feel comfortable, and enjoy being there.
So, you create the scents, you put flowers in the lobbies. What is it exactly you do?
Well, we work with perfumers to develop a fragrance that's exclusive to that particular client, and we diffuse it through the air conditioning system. So when guests walk into the space, they have an evenly diffused scent that's consistent all day long. And for music, we work with a music library that has over 5 million licensed tracks, and we will develop a music profile and provide that music that is heard in that space.
I know you're already working with some of the biggest hotel companies in the world, some very popular ones such as Pan Pacific Hotels and Resorts, which is Singapore based, the Hotel Nomi, and this hotel here that we're in at the moment, the Hotel Moon. How does it differ from a brand such as Pan Pacific, which has got many hotels around the world, to a small boutique hotel with around 40 or so rooms such as the Moon here in Singapore?
I think time is the critical factor there. When you're working with a smaller boutique property, we're generally working directly with the owners, which means the whole process is a shorter process, and we're not having to deal with many different department heads who have different ideas and different concepts. So the larger brands there's more people involved. It's a longer journey than it is working with a smaller boutique property.
Right. Do the brands, for example, like Pan Pacific, do they tend to want one particular scent throughout the group, or do they want to have individual scents that perhaps reflect the locality of the one particular hotel?
The way we've seen things evolving is that they're actually looking to have more of a uniform scent that runs across properties, but at the same time, there are clients who like the ideas of being able to have something that's a little bit more localized. The problem with the latter is that you start to dilute the brand identity. So you're building inconsistencies within that brand experience.
Right. And so then for a hotel such as Moon, which is very small, an individual property standalone, what would you recommend for a property such as this?
It boiled back down to the environment. The type of mood and ambience, and really what we wanted to reflect, and that was all part of the owner's vision.
Right. Now, staying with the scents for the moment, how many different scents are there, for example, and are they organic or are they ecologically friendly? Tell us about the scents.
We work with one of the top three fine fragrance houses in the world. They're responsible for developing perfumes like Anna Sui, Escada, Gucci, Paris Hilton, Dunhill. So we're working with people who are very much, the best in the world. We work with them on developing a scent concept and a brief, and there we have effectively an infinite selection of fragrances we can develop. The creations we have for our clients, they have up to around 45 ingredients. They are mostly synthetic, and we can also go for organic. The couple of things that people need to take into consideration is when you're using organic, you have they're more expensive to develop, because to develop enough rose petal oil to scent a football stadium would take a lot of roses to be grown for that. Whereas if you use it synthetically, it's a lot more affordable. Also, there's a bit of an issue in the market where people are saying that synthetic is bad for you and natural is good. One of the governing bodies, the International Fragrance Association, all of our work is actually works to their global guidelines from a health and safety aspect. And out of the 26 banned substances that you should not diffuse in the air, 18 are actually natural. So as long as people are being responsible in what they're doing and how they do it, and they're working with the right ingredients and they're working to the right guidelines with the right creators, they will be in good hands. The end result will be good, and it'll be one they'd be proud to put your name to.
Right, this all sounds very interesting. Then again, let's stay with a small hotel such as the Hotel Moon in Singapore, where we are at the moment. Small number of rooms, small number of facilities. Where are the hot zones? Let's say if you have a hotel such as this, where do you have different scents in different parts of the hotel? How does that work?
Well, for this property, we felt that the lobby, the lounge area and the bar was sort of the main, let's say, high traffic areas where guests will be arriving, departing, and people will be spending more time. So this is a space that we identified as the hot spot in this property.
Right, okay. And in terms of that, what type of scent did you choose for this particular property?
This one's actually got a blend of a couple of different elements we had from different fragrances, which the owner actually liked and we felt would give this property a bit of a nice, fresh, dynamic feel. So we've got a citrus top notes, we've got a more of a floral body to it. So it comes across as being elegant, sophisticated, and very nice as well with it.
Well, I have to say, it's one of the nicest smelling lobbies I've ever been in, which is saying something. But you don't just do the scent technology, but you're also doing the music here at the hotel as well, right?
Yep. I mean, besides just developing scents that are smelt in the lobby, we also can provide scent that would be smelt in guest rooms. So we have a system for that, which would be using a vase with reeds and filled with the appropriate scent. So, you know, Marina Bay Sands is one property, we provide that to their suites. Also for the limousine service, you know, a lot of hotels have their own limo, so they want to take their scent and their sounds actually to the limo. So we actually have a car diffuser that allows us to scent cars. So looking at music, there's lots of things we can do in music, whether it's going to be music that's heard on the website, heard on the telephone, heard in the limo, heard when they actually visit the property. So we try to look at it from the whole customer journey of reaching the space.
Continue.
We work with two major types of music libraries. One is a major label, which comprises all your EMI, your Time Warner. So if people want the Bee Gees, they want Elvis Presley, they want Justin Timberlake, they want Beyonce, we work with that library. And also another library which is private, which is unavailable to the public, but there's a lot of very high quality music that's licensed to it. So based upon what the client's requirements are, we'll actually start to work with these two different libraries and identify which one would have greater priority. And part of that would be trying to map out across the day the different moods at different times of the day. So if you want different, more relaxed music in the morning, but more upbeat in the afternoon, then we actually use technology as a way to manage that.
Right.
So, for example, we have a little media player like this unit. This goes on site, we plug it into their amplifier, plug it into the network, and this allows us to manage all the content remotely and look after the scheduling, where we actually have 14-day scheduling.
When you say look after the scheduling remotely, do you mean that's the front desk that has to take charge of it within the hotel, or do you, as your equal strategy?
We do this. We have clients as far away as Pan Pacific in North America, to clients in the Middle East, Starwood up in Tokyo, and other properties down in Indonesia, where we remotely manage all the content that runs in this unit. And you know, it also has about 60,000 tracks we pre-install on the hard drive.
So Pan Pacific in North America at the moment, in Canada possibly, you could literally change the music right this second of what somebody's listening to in that hotel?
If the GM called us and said, Simon, I want hip-hop tomorrow morning, they would have hip-hop tomorrow morning.
Well, excellent. We all know that Pan Pacific is a very happening hotel. I'm not sure if hip-hop would go down very well for breakfast, but still. So in terms of that, so this is all, to be honest, beginning to sound a little bit expensive. But this is a small hotel. How could a small hotel afford something like this?
I think when you put things into context, what they're charging for their room rates, the number of rooms, We can be sent in a small hotel lobby from literally as little as $20 a day, and we're talking Singapore dollars, not US. And from that being part of a three-year contract, we design the scent, we work the perfumers, we loan the technology, we look after the quarterly replenishments. So from $20 a day, you can send your hotel lobby, and that's all there is to it.
And would that sort of money include the music as well?
That'd be additional. Right. So you're looking for music, depending on how complex it would be or not. Again, you could be looking around the same figures.
So the music possibly that people can hear in the background at the moment, is this something that you've created exclusively for the Moon Hotel?
Yeah, this playlist came from a private label collection, and we created this playlist as a way to, you know, create a nice ambiance across the space of the day. without being too time specific here.
And what sort of money would be involved with something such as this?
Similar sort of figures I said before. You could be looking around $15-$20 a day, gives you a starting point for something that's got a very, you know, straightforward, non-sophisticated arrangement.
Right. Now, we mentioned Pan Pacific, you mentioned Starwood in Japan as well. How many hotels do you have working in your portfolio at the moment?
I think looking across the different services, from telephone, you know, music we're providing on the telephone, to the music we're providing the property, to what we're providing with Scent, we've probably, I mean, hotel-wise, off the top of the head, we've got about 80, 90 properties across the region.
By the end of 2011, how many are you looking for to have expanded that by?
I've been looking to expand that by about 40%.
Very good, very good. And which particular markets are you looking at primarily?
Southeast Asia has very much become a test case for us as to proof of concepts, make things work. I mean, we've got phenomenal things happening in China at the moment. China's really opened up as a market that's hungry at the high end of the market to be doing things well, and there they really need to differentiate their brands from others.
Right. Now, you mentioned earlier it can be a bit difficult to get into the brands, into the groups, because there's so much red tape and so much things to go through. Who are you trying to target primarily? I mean, all of your efforts, your marketing efforts, where is the majority of that? Is it going towards the boutique properties such as this, or going towards the big black winner, if you like, the groups?
I mean, for our focus is spread across the two. Boutiques are very much showing the larger brands how it can be done and how it should be done. So, you know, we spend time talking to the brands, you know, the larger global brands, as well as the small. So we have a split across the two.
Right, right. And in terms of the process, somebody's watching this in Phuket, in Samui, possibly in Malaysia, or even back up in Canada or the North America, and they're saying, I'd like to be part of this. I'd like to employ equal strategy. Are they allowed to test your products? What is the process? How does it work?
First, they get in contact with us, or we get in contact with the right person there. Basically, through having conversations, then we have an understanding of where they are with regards to their timeline, how much of a priority this is, really what their vision is. I mean, the vision's crucial for us because that's telling us where we need to be. And, you know, through those conversations, we get a good idea of understanding of how quickly they want to move forward with this or not. So, testing things, we very much found that once people start to share a lot of things with us, it's a journey we go on together. It isn't a case of pulling something out of the bag and saying, hi, this is the scent that's right for you, try it for 5 days, you'll like it, buy it. This is something that becomes very much an integral part of their business that they are part of creating. So we're creating something with them.
Yeah, okay, I've just spent a few billion, you know, a few million possibly on a small boutique hotel. I've just done the air conditioning loss. I don't really want to rip out ceilings and have to reinstall something. How simple is it to install the scent technology? The sound obviously is pretty easy, I take.
Yeah.
But how difficult is it to install the sound, the scent technology?
It's quite straightforward. It really depends on how large the space is. We connect to the air conditioning supply duct as a way to carry our scent vapor to that space. So it's quite straightforward. So, for example, we have a little black box here. This can comfortably cover a center space up to 1,000 square foot.
1,000 square foot?
1,000 square
foot. Which is how many square meters, roughly?
100.
Huh.
And inside it has a scent bottle, it has the pump, has a timer, and the tube from here runs out through the top, goes to the air conditioning duct, and there you've got the space scented. I mean, for larger applications, we're actually scenting one of the pavilions at the Shanghai Expo. And, you know, there we have a...
Which one, sorry?
It's one of the Chinese private enterprise pavilions, and there we use a very large system that's connected to that space. So we don't just provide one piece of technology for everyone. We gear our technology around what fits the requirements of each individual client and their needs.
Right. So from contacting you to agreeing on the fees, how long does that take?
Within 6 weeks, they can actually have a bespoke scent that no other business in the world has, which would smell the same.
Simon, on that note, I have to say this lobby does sound very, very nice. The music is great. On that note, I'd like to thank you very much for your time today, and I wish your business the best of luck.
Lovely, thank you.